So try to picture a map of your entire body across your brain. The size of different body parts depend on how much each body part is used. For example, eyes, lips, ears and mouth are largely represented across this map as they are used for sensation and function. Scientists found that this map has the ability to constantly change according to how you use your body. For example, the representation of fingertips on the brain of braille readers is much bigger than non-braille readers because they use them so much more. Equally, when a body part is used less, for example, a hand or arm after a stroke or brain injury, this representation on the map is then less. Intensive training of the upper limb during CIMT rewires brain activity and increases representation of the upper limb in the brain. Constraint-induced movement therapy has been shown to stimulate the brain to form new connections and grow new neurons. This process is called cortical reorganisation, which is quite simply put, rewiring of the brain. Research has proven that CIMT increases the size of the affected arm on the brain initially and when followed up 6 months later. This shows that CIMT affects not just the physical arm and hand, but actually causes cortical reorganisation in the brain that lasts even after the program has stopped. It is the changes in the brain that allow for improvements with CIMT to continue even after treatment has finished.